festivities with the opening contest in just a moment. To my left, ladies and gentlemen, the reigning Worldwide Wrestling Federation champion, Bob Backlund. As Bob Backlund is set to square off against 6'9" of the big cat Ernie Ladd in the title defense this Monday night, notwithstanding, of course, in Madison Square Garden as well, the return of Bruno Sammartino, who faces superstar Billy Graham. But it's you who will defend the belt against the big cat.
Yes, I'd like to take an opportunity to wish Bruno Sammartino all the luck in the world against Graham. I know how bad he wants him, but I got my hands full that night, too, and I'm going to need all the luck I can get in wrestling Ladd. He's the biggest man that I've ever faced, and he's got an opportunity to win the Worldwide Wrestling Federation title back in for the Grand Wizard, and I know the Grand Wizard's got him pretty keyed up. The Grand Wizard knows a lot of my wrestling tactics, and I'm sure that he's going to give it 100%, and we'll find out who's the better man Monday night in the Garden.
Best of luck to you, Bob, against the biggest man you've ever faced.
Thank you very much.
Bob Backlund against the big cat, Ernie Ladd. Speaking of the number one contender, you ready?
There's no question. I'm trimmed down. I'm tapered real well. I'm in the greatest shape of my life, and there's no question. And I was in the back room, and I heard Bob Backlund. He was talking in his low tone of voice. Only because he's a little nervous. He has this fear about the big man coming in. Now, well, it's no question. I don't blame you. If I had a man towering over the way I'm towering over you and the type of athlete that I am, you know, I would do anything. I'm not going to let this golden opportunity pass me. I'm going to tell you people out in TV land right now, once and for all, you've probably already missed the two biggest events of your life, the birth of your mother and the birth of your father. So whatever you do in life, do not miss the third big event of your life. That is yours truly, the king of the square circle, Penn and Bob Backlund, right in the middle of the ring in Madison Square Garden. 1, 2, 3. October the 23rd, I am going to pin you, Bob Backlund. My prediction for the world's champion, Ernie Ladd, a new champion, a new champion, a new champion, a new champion of the world. Yours truly, Ernie Ladd, Madison Square Garden, October the 23rd. Don't be nervous, Bob Backlund. I know it's going to be a contest. I know you're not going to lay down and give it to me. I'm going to fight for it. I'm going to take it. Well, Bob Backlund, just to let you know, I am from the ghetto, and you have to fight to survive in the ghetto. You have to do any and everything that's required to come out as a man. And you can say I'm quite a bit of a man. I've done a lot of things. I've even had to backstab. I've had to hit people in the head. I've had to do numerous things in order just to survive. And I don't want to go back to the ghetto. When I go back to the ghetto, it'll only be by choice, Bob Backlund, not by force. And don't you ever forget it. Don't you ever, ever forget it. And my manager has a devious mind of scheming.
The big cat, Ernie Ladd, opposes Bob Backlund in the championship match this Monday night in Madison Square Garden.
Look at you, beautiful, from your hair to your Fava leather boots, specially priced at $30. Fava leather boots reflect your sense of fashion, your smart way with money. Fava leather boots, just $30. Why pay $50 or more when good leather boots are just $30 at Fava? You and your Fava boots, beautiful from every angle.
Wrestling exhibition requires discretionary viewer participation.
Welcome to another action-packed card of championship wrestling. These matches are sanctioned and supervised by the State Athletic Commission. Chief Deputy Commissioners are Jimmy Mina and John Esposito. The timekeeper at the bell, J.P. Mina. Referees for this hour are Dick Worley, Lou Super, and John Stanley. And I'm your ring announcer for championship wrestling, Gary Capetta. The first match is set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first the manager of champions, the Grand Wizard of Wrestling. And his protege, from Atlanta, Georgia, weighing 291 pounds, Luke Graham. And his opponent, from New Zealand, weighing 228 pounds, the New Zealand Flash, Jim Ray.
Jimmy Ray, against Luke Graham to open up things here on Championship Wrestling. We're set for the action to commence.
Pausing for a commercial note. This Monday night, a busy night for professional wrestling in the tri-state area. What with the wrestling set to get underway in Danbury, Connecticut, this Monday night, featuring the skills of dynamic Dino Bravo. Scheduled as well to compete this Monday night, only in New Jersey, in Spotswood, New Jersey, will be the tag team combination of Tony Garea and Larry Zbysko. Also, Jay Strongbow will be meeting individual competition on the card this Monday night in Spotswood.
Luke Graham powers there across the back of Jimmy Ray. Ray's gained a little weight since his first appearance here in the Worldwide Wrestling Federation, and certainly has gained a great deal of experience. Jim Ray giving away a tremendous amount of size and weight to Luke Graham. Luke easily scooping Jimmy Ray up. His left hand, Luke's left hand, around the throat of Jim Ray, concealing the obvious choke from the referee. Jim Ray now off balance across the top rope at the total mercy of Luke Graham. Continuing to take advantage of the opponent, Jim Ray. And, you know, man, that's as big as Luke Graham is, at 300-plus pounds, has the abilities Luke Graham has. It's really, there's no reason at all for Luke Graham to have to resort to these type tactics to win a match. He could very easily do it using the letter of the law. Scoop again by Luke Graham. Rams the back there. Rather lays him in the corner, actually. Positioning the legs now so that they're locked up in that rope. And Luke Graham stomps into the midsection of Jim Ray. Luke right back over and just eating up Jim Ray. Ray hanging upside down, almost motionless now as the referee comes over to check him out. I can't believe the referee won't stop this match. The referee allowing Luke Graham to pretty much have his way with young Jim Ray. No mercy at all against Jim Ray. Jim Ray is a much better wrestler than we are seeing at this moment. Certainly was a great pleasure last week to have with us Bruno Sammartino, the living legend, and he looks better than he's ever looked. Here comes Jim Ray now. This is the Jim Ray that we have grown to see here in the Worldwide Wrestling Federation, doing very well against Big Luke now. Jim Ray coming on strong, forearm strike. Luke whoops from one side of the ring to the other. Jim Ray moving right in, has his man in trouble now. Ray getting it right back to Luke Graham. Big Lucas, however, with one shot there into the ribs, sends Jim Ray to the canvas. Just kind of lays down across the chest, and it's all over for Jim Ray. Luke apparently going down into the tights and
picking up something to assist him as Jim Ray came off the ropes. Luke Graham hammered into the chest of Jimmy Ray, and it was all over.
Return, ladies and gentlemen, with Eric and Pierre, the Yukon Lumberjack.
Me too. And talking about shape, does my apartment look good? I went to see Mr. Do the living room, and the prices were so low, I did the bedroom too, and the salesman was adorable, just like you. And you know something? They delivered right when they said they would. You could have knocked me over with a feather. Well, I gotta run now. Next time you need furniture, see Siemens first. Oh, and I was running with him. Nobody...
This Thursday night, professional wrestling has the pleasure of returning to Poughkeepsie, New York. And at the Mid-Hudson Civic Center, ladies and gentlemen, scheduled to compete on the wrestling card will be the honorary Indian Chief Jay Strongbow, will be as well. Standing to my right, Captain Louis Albano's tag team tandem of Eric and Pierre, the Yukon Lumberjacks.
Well, I'm very pleased to be up around the Poughkeepsie area because they have the fans that really appreciate fine wrestling talent. And bringing the world champion Lumberjacks up to that area has got to be a thrill for the people, for myself, and for the Lumberjacks. Because, as I said, we have many, many, many fans that come out to see us, and a beautiful Civic Center arena downtown that always gives me a thrill. And I'm sure the Lumberjacks feel the same way. It's going to be a great day in the Poughkeepsie area. The whole town is being rebuilt. It's a beautiful area, and we're proud to be in Poughkeepsie.
Captain Louis Albano, proud to be in Poughkeepsie, as the Yukon Lumberjacks, Eric and Pierre, will be meeting an extraordinary tag team combination in their own right this Thursday night.
Here's Lee Miles, Fort Lesson and Transmission Care. Question, if your transmission is slipping or struggling or moaning and groaning, what check should a transmission shop do first?
Road test. Inspection on
the list. That's two. How many checks in all to diagnose the nature of your problem?
11 checks.
Right. And if you want to be sure these 11 checks are done right and done free, where should you go?
To the pros.
And who are the pros?
E. Miles.
Take care for your transmission.
The following attraction is a special tag team match. It is set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. It is a non-title match. Introducing first the manager, Captain Louis Albano. And now the participants. In the corner to my right, from Columbus, Ohio, weighing 239 pounds, Frank Williams. And his partner, from Kansas City, Missouri, weighing 253 pounds, the former Texas Brass Knuckles champion, Davey O'Hannon. And their opponents, they are the current Worldwide Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, total combined weight, 551 pounds, Eric and Pierre, the Yukon Lumberjacks.
Big rugged tag team tandem here in the Lumberjacks. We're about trying to cool them off a bit, apparently. The bell has rung. We're set for the action to commence here in the tag team match.
The following is commercial in content. Ivan Koloff, the Russian Bear, stomping his way in the Poughkeepsie, New York, this Thursday night. At the Mid-Hudson Civic Center, Ivan Koloff will be joined by Larry Zbysko. He'll also be joined by a super heavyweight extraordinaire, making reference to, of course, 420 some odd pounds of Crusher Blackwell. So Blackwell, Koloff, and many others scheduled to compete this Thursday night in Poughkeepsie.
Test of strength there on the part of O'Hannon and Big Eric. Thus far, pretty evenly matched situation. You'd think Eric, being the larger of the two, would have the advantage.
Oh,
trying to put Big Eric down. Has the advantage as far as leverage is concerned at the moment, and down to the knee goes Eric. Lou Albano not happy about that.
Happy because I feel there was some trickery involved. Eric would not have got off his feet, but the man pulled his hair in a tight from the rear. If you're paying attention, you can see some shady underhanded work going on. Watch it. Pay attention, McMahon. My men don't go down.
The voice of Lou Albano. Oh, Hanan. Sit to the buckle. Reeled now. No! Nice reversal. Turning the tide there on Big Eric. Perhaps they'll try this again. Lock, no, O'Hannon said, just fool you a little bit. Nice maneuver there by O'Hannon. Later on this week, we'll be seeing Dino Bravo grace this squared circle. Nice reversal there by the lumberjack, and a double reversal. Well, lined earlier, the presence of Ivan Koloff will be seen in the squared circle here. And of course, our feature match, Bob Backlund, Peter Maivia against Victor Rivera and Spiro Azeri on the tag team tandem of Fred Bussey. Nice takedown by the lumberjack. Williams yet to get into the match, and the same can be said for the tag team partner of Eric, the other lumberjack, Pierre. There's the extended hand, now Pierre comes in. I mentioned earlier the fact that Bruno Sammartino's presence was more than appreciated last week on Championship Wrestling. Apparently, not only from me, but we have received since that time telegrams and all kind of letters and what have you, stating that, they'd like to see more of Bruno Sammartino. They'd like to have more of Bruno right back here with us, because it really gives you an insider standpoint to hear Bruno's commentary. His opponent, Pierre, slugging it out. O'Hannon back to his feet. O'Hannon coming on strong. Pierre whipped to the far side. He was really thrown in there. O'Hannon moving in rather slowly, but nevertheless was effective. Again, the whip to the buckle. O'Hannon, no. Put the finishing touches on Pierre. If he had landed with that knee, it would have been all over for the lumberjack. But Pierre showing quite a bit of agility in moving out of the way a moment ago. Now Eric, through the ropes and wide open is Davey O'Hannon. Back bank now, Black Williams steps through. Williams' first appearance in the tag team match. Williams, all right. Frank Williams winds up and lets him have another one. Oh, just like that, however, things are turned around. These lumberjacks, big, powerful men, they can take a lot of punishment. Williams whipped right into Pierre. Unusual maneuver. Now you see the lumberjack set one another up here for the entrance, and the wide open was Frank Williams. Did a consultation there with Eric and Lou Albano a moment ago. Frank Williams jumps in a rope, the elbow finds its mark. Again, we'll see that frequent tag. Williams set up, cannot make the tag. This is, of course, what you try and do, keep your opposition from tagging their partners. Dick Worley to make certain that that is not a chokehold. We made reference earlier in the program to the tag team match with Maivia and Bob Backlund, the reigning champion, meeting Victor Rivera and Arion. This is unquestionably the toughest test yet for the undefeated combination of Bob Backlund and Peter Maivia. Frank Williams whips in a rope and waiting for him, Pierre. Caught him right in the chest. Again, the extended hand. Can't not quite make the tag. Frank Williams cannot, however, the lumberjack tag. A scoop by Eric. Ooh. Powell driver down for 1-2, and well, you can count the three very easily. A shoulder breaker there used by Eric. And the lumberjack is going to chalk up one more victory.
Time of the match, 7 minutes, 18 seconds, and your winners, the Yukon Lumberjacks.
Yukon Lumberjacks once again victorious. We shall return as we continue with more wrestling in a moment.
Make your front end tight, make your motor run right, align your wheels precisely, but to put it very nicely, hurry on down to Great Bear. If your shocks are gone, we'll put a new set in, and when you hear the price, you're sure to grin. Now at Great Bear, a premium oil change with filter, lube, and wheel alignment included for only $13.95 complete. Hurry on down to Great Bear for an oil change and peace of mind. Drive on in anytime to Great Bear. Great parts, great service, Great Bear.
Oh, no. Look who's here.
Hiya, boys. Here, Midas is guaranteeing foreign car mufflers.
Mr. Creedy, you don't drive a foreign car.
Sister Creedy does.
Look, stand there, guys. Midas has...
From now on, foreign car owners can take advantage of Midas, too. If anything goes wrong with our American or foreign car muffler, Midas will replace it free as long as you own your car.
I guarantee. See you again, boys.
One week from tonight, ladies and gentlemen, professional wrestling appears in Manhattan at the Power Memorial Academy. That's at 161 West 61st Street. And among the principal schedule to compete will be, to the right of the Grand Wizard of Wrestling, Rugged Luke Graham.
You might say, McMahon, this is the gentleman who's going to supply the power at the Power Academy. Right here he is, the one, the only, the infamous Luke Graham. The man who's always victorious.
Don't be modest, boss. Tell them how great I am.
Everybody knows the greatness. All they have to do is look at you, look at your record, and then be on hand to see power in action as only Luke Graham can deliver it.
Luke Graham putting his forces to work at the Power Memorial Academy in Manhattan 1 week from tonight.
The following bout is set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing to my right, from Sicily, weighing 248 pounds, Tony Russo. And his opponent, from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing 248 pounds, Special Delivery Jones.
Special Delivery against Tony Russo, and here we go with the action.
The following is brought to you by Capital Wrestling Corporation. One of the greatest nights ever in professional wrestling history is set to get underway this Monday night in Madison Square Garden. And superstar Billy Graham, standing in the comeback trail of the living legend of professional wrestling, Bruno Sammartino. The Worldwide Wrestling Federation Heavyweight Championship up for grabs. Champion Bob Backlund laying it all on the line against a giant in his own right, 6 feet 9 inches, of the big cat, Ernie Ladd.
SD, doing quite well for himself thus far against Tony Russo. SD, one of the more popular athletes in the Worldwide Wrestling Federation, I think principally because to his attitude and his gentlemanly qualities outside of the ring, as well as those admirable qualities on the inside. Nice maneuver again. Oh, but look at that flying tackle by Russo. No, sir. Nice maneuver by SD, who turns the tide on Tony Russo and takes him down again. Jones, who has continued his routine in the gymnasiums and what have you, as well as on the mat, claims that you never stop learning things here in the Worldwide Wrestling Federation. And Jones with a proper type attitude, really, because he is always looking to learn something new. Russo trying to stretch the hamstring area of SD Jones. Russo again down across the leg. A release of the hair that SD Jones had a moment ago. Jones will take you on fair and square in most every occasion. However, if you turn the tide on him and want to play rough, Jones capable of adjusting his style in that way as well. Russo drawing to work on that left leg of SD Jones. Dick Worley, the referee, right there in perfect position to put the count on SD. This, of course, not a pinning combination at all. Nice maneuver by Jones, able to get a little leverage with the other leg. But Russo continues to go to work on the left leg of his opponent, SD Jones. And once you have an advantage, Russo is certainly a firm believer in keeping it. Look at that head scissor. Nice maneuver by Jones. Jones still favoring that leg, however. Semblance of a Boston Crab, although with one leg there, and you don't often see that maneuver by SD Jones. Left hand finds its mark. Headbutt. Both men on their feet. SD Jones now. No, nice reversal. Jones in the middle, and Mucky flips his man. One, two, three, and four. Let's take another look at it. SD Jones, who is injured, having his problem, whipped Tony Russo to the corner. Jones moving right in now with the legs right there. Rolls him over in perfect pinning position and chalk up a victory for SD Jones.
Me too. And talking about shape, does my apartment look good? I went to
idea for Halloween.
Get the wholesome Halloween treat kids love. Wrigley's Gum.
Ladies and gentlemen, in Madison Square Garden this Monday night, Bruno Sammartino to my right opposes superstar Billy Graham. I'm quite certain you are hoping for victory in your return to the Garden this Monday.
I am most definitely hoping for victory. I feel victory, Vince. I feel it in my bones and every muscle in my body. But most important, Vince, I feel I can't wait for these 2 days, because it seems like 2 months away. I am so thrilled, so absolutely thrilled out of my head to be going back to Madison Square Garden in front of all those beautiful people that have supported me for so many, many years. I hope that I can give them one gift to eliminate this thief from professional wrestling. I'm thrilled to death, Vince.
far as the accusations hurled by Superstar in that you're not the same man you were at one time?
I'm going to show him that I am three times the man that he is, and I'm going to show him that I'm in better shape than I've ever been in my life because I completely dedicate myself to my profession, especially when I got to meet the likes of him.
Bruno Sammartino appearing this Monday night in Madison Square Garden against Superstar Billy Graham.
The following attraction is set for one ball with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my left, weighing 230 pounds from Bombay, India, Sabu. And his opponent, from Montreal, Canada, 248 pounds, Dino Bravo.
Bravo against newcomer Sabu. Here we go.
The following is commercial and content. 1 week from tonight, professional wrestling appears in Manhattan at the Power Memorial Academy. The address is 161 West 61st Street. Scheduled to compete on the wrestling card at the Power Memorial Academy of Manhattan will be the Iron Greek Spiros Arion. Also scheduled, the Paramount Samoan Chief Peter Maivia. And also on the same card will be Chief Jay Strongbow. So wrestling set for Manhattan 1 week from tonight.
Miss there for Sabu against Dino Bravo. Nice takedown by Dino Bravo, and did a counter too. He almost got the impression that Sabu was waiting and resting a bit for at least. There's a small package of shoulders down from our vantage point. The referee a little slow in putting the count on Sabu. Headlock applied here, and Bravo shoves him to the ropes. Down goes Bravo, and Sabu is reeled back to the ropes as well. Leg takedown, rips it around, and in control is Dino Bravo. Scheduled up next will be the Bear, as in the Russian Bear, Ivan Koloff. Then, of course, following that, our featured confrontation, Victor Rivera and Spiro Sirion, Fred Vasi tag team tandem against the dynamic combination of Bob Backlund and Peter Maivia, thus far undefeated in tag team competition. Count of two, and Sabu just able to get that left shoulder up. Bravo, a real powerhouse at 248 pounds, and he doesn't lack as far as speed and agility is concerned either. Bravo, one of the few athletes who pretty much has it all. Takedown by Bravo. Sabu, forearm smashed there to the chest area, one across the back of the neck. A right hand finds its mark to the side of the head. Another one. Bravo obviously dazed there in the corner now. A rake of the face a moment ago by Sabu. Bravo turning it around. Quick left jab there. Sabu to the roof coming off. Ooh, what a right hand that was. Bravo easily scooping up Sabu. Body slam. Sabu coming off the rope. Here's a drop kick by Dino Bravo. Bravo sends him to the rope one more time and into the airplane spin. And watch Bravo go. Dumps him down. Hose him over. Lifts the leg. Two and on the three. Victory for Dino Bravo beating newcomer Sabu from Bombay, India.
The time of the match, 3 minutes 36 seconds, and the winner with the airplane spin, Dino Bravo.
Dino Bravo victorious. Let's go back in time and take another look at a patented Dino Bravo dropkick. Sabu Entering this ring for the first time, thought he had a pretty good chance against Bravo, but that's just one of the things that Sabu could not handle. We shall return with the Russian Bear, Ivan Kolov.
Know what? I can chew gum again. Big deal? It is to me. I had to give up gum because it stuck to my dental work. But with Freedent gum from Wrigley's, I can enjoy chewing gum again. Fact is, until I'd found Freedent, I'd forgotten how fresh and clean my mouth and breath could feel anytime. Freedent in peppermint and spearmint. You'll like it.
Feel free to chew Freedent.
It won't stick to most dental work.
Freedent gum.
Nothing destroys a new car quicker than Mother Nature and her favorite killer, rust. But now new car dealers have Polyglycote rust-proofing shield. When tested against the seven leading rust-proofing products, only Polyglycote stopped rust through completely. That's why only Polyglycote can offer the incredible 7-year warranty. Polyglycote rust-proofing, so effective its warranty is renewable. Total 14-year protection. And if during that time your car has rust through, we'll repair it free. So forget about rust for 14 years with Polyglycote rust-proofing shield.
Starting October 2nd, enjoy more laughs with the legendary Ernie Kovacs on Take a Good Look, the show that brings back some of television's brightest moments. Watch it weeknights at 11:30 here on Channel 9.
Heart doesn't miss a beat. Heart's new album, Dog and Butterfly. Rock with pride and beauty on Portrait Records and Tapes.
Pausing for this commercial break, the wrestling fans of Torrington, Connecticut can look forward to wrestling once again headed your way. Scheduled to compete at the Torrington High School on Saturday night, the 4th of November, will be Chief Jay Strongbow, who will be making his very first appearance in Torrington, Connecticut. Jay Strongbow is joined on the card by Dominic DiNucci, by Ivan Kolov as well, so indeed it should be quite a night of pro wrestling set for Saturday, the 4th of November in Torrington, Connecticut.
Showing no mercy at all on Charlie Brown. Nice block there by Brown. Brown coming on strong. The Bear rocking and reeling in trouble. However, just like that,
It can happen and does happen so many times in professional wrestling. A split second and things are turned around completely. Charlie Brown whipped to the rope to Bear, waiting for that back body drop. Brown almost was able to hook the hips in a sunset flip. Koloff scooped up Charlie Brown, delivers a tremendous body slam. Reversal this time, Brown hung on, and a nice maneuver. Ooh, he ran right into that knee. Oh, Koloff on the apron. Koloff on the top rope, leaps off, and the knee across the chest. You can forget about this one. Koloff, along with his manager, Lou Albano, victorious here over Charlie Brown.
The time of the match, 2 minutes, 42 seconds, and your winner, the Russian Bear, Ivan Koloff.
Ivan Koloff, victorious over Charlie Brown. Let's go back and take a look at that leap off the top rope. Well, here you see the reversal. And then from there, on to set his man up after the reversal and what have you. There's Koloff and leaping off the knee, pointed in a downward fashion. And of course, it went squarely across the chest. Just imagine the impact.
Psst. Know how to buy a used car cheap? At a nationwide auction. The big auction is this Sunday at noon at Kings County Nationwide in Brooklyn at 3rd Avenue and 20th Street. Come in and inspect the cars Monday through Friday from 10 a.m., then make your bid on Sunday at noon. Always over 100 cars and free door prizes, too, at Kings County Nationwide, 3rd Avenue at 20th Street in Brooklyn. For details, call 499-6161. 499-6161.
Meineke Discount Mufflers shatters prices. Any make, any model, American cars, Japanese cars, German cars, English cars, Swedish cars, French cars, you name it.
That's right, Molly. Thousands of car owners have taken advantage of Meineke Discount Mufflers prices. So when you need a muffler, check Meineke's low prices. It's easy.
Because chances are there's a Meineke shop near your home. Drive in today.
Mufflers install from as low as $16.93. No charge for installation. A real value.
This is the final event. It is set for one fall to the curfew. Tag team match. Introducing in the ring, the manager, the Hollywood fashion plate, Blassie, Fred Blassie. And his tag team combination, from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing 256 pounds, Victor Rivera. And his partner, from Athens, Greece, weighing 268 pounds, Spiros Arion. And their opponents, soon to be making their way to the ring, led by their manager, the Golden Boy, Arnold Skolin. From the Isle of Samoa, weighing 285 pounds, High Chief Peter Maivia.
Taking this commercial pause, the wrestling fans of South Plainfield, New Jersey, are surely looking forward to an upcoming Thursday night card of pro wrestling to be held on the 2nd of November. Scheduled for South Plainfield will be a wrestling card involving Chief Peter Maivia, Tony Garea also on the card, along with Spiros Arion, Chief Jay Strongbow, and many others. So it's wrestling in South Plainfield, New Jersey, Thursday night, the 2nd of November.
All right. My man. Great act, but over. little confusion there. Nice body slam. Seemed to be a little confusion at the outset as to which one of these two principals, Bob Backlund or Peter Maivia, would enter the ring to begin the match. Arnold Skolin, the manager, straightened it out, however, sending Maivia in there. Says, no, sir, I'm not coming in there. You come out to get me. Nice reversal. But lightning-like speed is possessed by Bob Backlund. Backlund reversing. block, however. Rivera just able to get out of the way in the nick of time. Ooh. Frequent tag made by Arion and Victor Rivera. And they are really going to work on the Worldwide Wrestling Federation champion. Look at Fred Plassier in the background. There's nothing he'd like better than to get to Bob Backlund. He loves every moment of this. Scullin having a word with Maivia, wanting Maivia to come in to help out, I believe. Arnold, just like everyone else, can plainly see this two-on-one is really doing a lot of damage to champion Bob Backlund. Able to make the tie. Headbutt. Might be attacking Backlund again. Backlund had just been able to recoup a bit. He had taken a lot of punishment in there a moment ago. But apparently he's doing all right. Back body drop by Victor Rivera. Frequent back man again. So it's clear what they're trying to do here. Arnold Skolin, the manager, on his feet, and almost a pin by Backlund. Across the knee. Arion over one, two, and oh, the foot. The foot on the rope, Fred Blackie shoves it back away. Arion ripped the buckle loose from the corner and Backlund right down in there. And the Tigers made it, and they're really doing a number on Bob Backlund. Reaching for the tag. Finally making it. Backlund really took a lot of play. What? It looks like Maivia tagged Backlund again. Backlund, who hasn't recuperated at all. And Backlund and Skolin are obviously having a few words over that one. Brick in the face. It's Victor Rivera all over Bob Backlund. The champion in a lot of trouble. Oh, my, what a crushing super. One, cannot put him away. Attesting to the strength and stamina of Bob Backlund. But how long can this double team continue? The knee of Arion to the midsection. And Bob Backlund taking a beating here, I'll tell you. Abdominal stretch. It could very well be all over. No, he finally takes him down. Maivia's looking down at Arnold Skolin. And meanwhile, it's Skolin and Maivia having words, and it couldn't happen at a most inopportune time. Backlund absolutely being crushed over there by Carlos Arion and Victor Rivera. And Skolin and the fans do not like what they see here. No, sir. Backlund in serious trouble. Backlund coming over to tag Maivia. Where is he? He's nowhere to be found. Maivia, having his words with Arnold Skolin, did not make the tag with Backlund. And Backlund in the corner has his head rammed to the buckle. Maivia. Not making a tag. But meanwhile, Bob Backlund is taking the brunt of it. Victor Rivera pulls Backlund over the top rope and out to the concrete floor. And Maivia is not even out helping Bob Backlund up. Skolin, how they work. Oh, no, I can't believe that didn't happen. That didn't happen. Backlund. Every Arnold Skolin. Bob Backlund is. I can't bump. My
be a ripping his shirt off Skullin. That might be a choking Arnold Skullin. Barbier is eating Arnold Skullin out. Bob Backlund just getting into the ring. Barbier has turned on Arnold Skullin, and Barbier is eating him out. Bob Backlund coming in out. Barbier over Bob Backlund. Barbier going to save forearm smackdown. Triple team effort. Lefrey trying to maintain order, but Marvia is just, and now look at this. Marvia hammering into Bob Backlund. A triple team here. Bob Backlund trying to get over to help his manager. And Marvia is just all over. Finally, Bravo, Tony Urea, and a whole horde of wrestlers come in. And my beer, let's just look what he has done to Arnold Skullin. Arnold Skullin crushed physically by Peter Maivia, and has to be crushed emotionally as well. And you can certainly say the same for Bob Backlund.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 9 minutes, 42 seconds, both teams have been disqualified. Double disqualification.
Arnold being helped out here by Bravo. We'll get out of the way. Arnold Skullin, as you can see, in bad shape here, being helped out by Zbyszko and many others. If we could have a word, Bob.
What happened? Why did that happen? Am I dreaming? Did the whole world get me? What happened? What did that happen? What happened? I'll kill it.
You heard the words of Bob Backlund, and what has to be one of the most despicable things we've seen in a long time in the Worldwide Wrestling Federation. Peter Maivia turning on Bob Backlund, turning on Arnold Skullin, destroying him. The last of that tag team combination we'll ever see, I know. And they were so close to a championship try. Bob Backlund, incensed. Join us next week for more. Championship Wrestling. My name is Vince McMahon. Scheduled here this week, we'll be seeing Crusher Blackwell take on individual competition. Also scheduled, Victor Rivera. The Yukon Lumberjacks, the tag team champions, will see action in a non-title tag team match. And then, ladies and gentlemen, to open up things, Luke Graham will face Tony Garea, notwithstanding a special six-man tag team match on the card, as Ivan Koloff, Stand-A-Man Stasiak, and Johnny Rods oppose SD Special Delivery Jones, Larry Zbyszko, and Dino Bravo. We shall return with the opening contest as Luke Graham opposes Tony Garea in just a moment.
On Monday night, November the 20th, professional wrestling returns to Madison Square Garden, scheduled to compete on the Wrestling Spectacular in the Garden. On this date will be Dino Bravo squaring off against superstar Billy Graham. Will be as well the Battle of the Giants. 6 feet 9 inches of the big cat Ernie Ladd squaring off against 7 feet 4 or 5 inches of the one and only Andre the Giant. But at this moment, ladies and gentlemen, let's bring on Bob Backlund, the reigning Worldwide Wrestling Federation champion. Bob Backlund meeting an individual whom he thought would be the last individual he'd ever have to face anywhere in the world, much less here in Madison Square Garden.
Why, Vince? Why did this happen to me? Why did this happen to me, Peter Maivia? Maivia, why did you do that? My best friend! Why? The best friend that I thought I had in the world! Why? You trusted somebody. You believe in them. Why did you do it to me? And my manager. You're gonna have to pay.
Bob Backlund unquestionably upset as a result of what happened last week here with Peter Maivia. It was a despicable display of action. Maivia, of course, will be meeting Bob Backlund in the main event in Madison Square Garden. And somebody will pay the dues. As well as the individual standing to my right, 6 feet 9 inches, Ernie Cat Ladd, meeting a man who's bigger than you. And
you know what I'm shaking my head about? Not about Andre the Dummy. I'm so disappointed at the fact, and I'm so happy that Peter Maivia finally saw the light. He finally saw the light. He knew when he had something real good. I had beat this Bob Backlund half to death. The man is still injured. Maivia is going in and takes the title. No question about it, Maivia is the title holder. He's the champion. And now, back to this Andre the Dummy. We're talking about a man X amount of feet tall. We're talking about a man X amount of inches wide. No question. They forgot one thing to put in that big frame. A brain. The man has the IQ of a boiled egg. He stayed up all night studying for a blood test to get a wrestling license. How can he get in the square circle and defeat the king of the square circle? The king of the square circle. I have the mind of the Wiz instructed me and tell him what to do and directed me on to the championship. No question about Andre the Dummy. You're a big man. You're about the size of an ox. And you're about twice as smart as an ox. And you want the king of wrestling.
The big cat Ernie Ladd opposing Andre the Giant, and Peter Maivia will meet Bob Backlund in Madison Square Garden.
Here's a good idea for Halloween. Wrigley's gum. My kids love it, and it's the treat I approve of. That's because I know Wrigley's Spearmint, Double Mint, Juicy Fruit, or Big Red Gum is a wholesome treat for kids. It won't spoil their appetite. Each stick is neatly wrapped, ready to hand out, and there's great value in a variety of package sizes. I like this new 50-stick bag. Wrigley's gum is the best idea for Halloween.
Get the wholesome Halloween treat kids love. Wrigley's gum. What do you think of the Midas Foreign Car Muffler Guarantee?
It's a great day for my Datsun.
A triumph for my Triumph.
A victory for my Volvo.
From now on, you can Midasize your foreign car and get the same famous guarantee we give American cars. It says if anything ever goes wrong, Midas will replace the muffler free as long as you own your car. Foreign car owners, now more than ever, it pays to Midasize.
What they do for my Subaru?
Following wrestling exhibition requires discretionary viewer participation.
Welcome to another action-packed card of championship wrestling. These matches are sanctioned and supervised by the State Athletic Commission. Chief Deputy Commissioners are Jimmy Mina and John Esposito. The timekeeper at the bell, J.P. Mina. Referees for this hour are Dick Worley, Lou Super, and John Stanley. And I'm your ring announcer from Championship Wrestling, Gary Capetta. The first match in the ring is set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first the manager, the Grand Wizard of Wrestling, and his protege from Atlanta, Georgia, weighing 291 pounds, Luke Graham. And his opponent, from Auckland, New Zealand, weighing 248 pounds, Tony Garea.
Delivery of the principles, and this should really be some match to open up things here. Tony Garea, well-conditioned athlete against the big 300-pound Luke Graham, and here we go.
Closing for a commercial note, professional wrestling appears in South Plainfield, New Jersey, this Thursday night, the 2nd of November. Set to appear in South Plainfield, New Jersey on this date will be Tony Garea. Tony Garea is certainly an individual holding a great deal of popularity in the Worldwide Wrestling Federation, and we wish him well in his efforts to defeat quite an extraordinary opponent as pro wrestling appears in South Plainfield, New Jersey on Thursday night, the 2nd of November.
Full Nelson there applied by Tony Garea. Dick Worley over to make sure that there's not going to be any hair pulling on the part of Luke Graham. Takedown by Lucas. Incidentally, ladies and gentlemen, later on we will have an explanation from one of the principals that were involved in that absolute melee that we saw last week with Peter Maivia and Bob Backlund as they entered the ring as tag team partners when they faced Victor Rivera and Spiro Zarion. We will have an explanation as to why some of the events happened as they did. That explanation will come later on in the program. Dick Worley warning Luke Graham of his tactics. Tony has certainly proven one of the favorites in the Worldwide Wrestling Federation. And Luke, 300 plus pounds there, laying him in there against Tony Garea. Really come from all walks of life and all ages here to see professional wrestling. Dick Worley puts the brakes down on Luke Graham, not before Luke hammers down to the chest with a forearm smash, and of course you see the blatant chokehold. You know, you have to hand it to the officials many occasions. Dick Worley will stand right in there and stand right up to the likes of Luke Graham, knowing full well that, oh, look at that! Luke setting Tony Garea up for the back body drop. Tony able to hook the rope, stop the momentum, and lift the foot right into the chest and shoulder. Things have turned around here. Oh, no. Tony right in there, too. The shoulder of Luke Graham hammered to the corner. Tony Garea not letting up at all on that hammerlock either. You can't blame him. Things were reversed. You know full well that Luke would take advantage. Luke steps to the rope. Dick Worley has to break it up. Tony right back over with the same hold and brings Luke to the middle of the ring. Buckle again by Tony Garea. Garea had a handful of hair. Ooh, Tony coming down hard now to the shoulder of Luke Graham. That left arm and shoulder must be smarting by now. Almost submitting the referee. Dick Worley asking Luke if he wants to submit, but Luke hooks the bottom rope there and the hold will be broken. Continuing to work on the left arm. Luke Graham for the ride now, and oh, no!
slam into the iron ring post. And Graham being consoled by his manager, the Grand Wizard. Up to six. Tony Garea wanted to go after him, apparently. And Garea was not in a neutral corner. Back out again. Luke Graham takes full advantage of the bit of respite here. Takes full advantage of the pin count. Luke adjusting his fight. Distracted by the Grand Wizard, as was referee Dick Worley a moment ago. And this has certainly given Luke Graham an opportunity. Look at that! Nice retaliation by Tony Garea. Luke Graham on the outside, once again being countered by referee Dick Worley. Maria takes full advantage of it. Tony hauling Luke in the hard way. Luke stays, and Luke is upset, a bit wobbly there as he's on his feet. The fingers out and apparently struck Tony Garea in the eyes. Tony beating Luke Graham in a punch. Uppercut sent Luke to the canvas. The Wizard again distracting the referee as now Tony Garea picks up the momentum. Butt of the chin. Luke up on his feet. Not for long, and this continues. Luke trying to shake it off, but unable to put up his hands in defense. Perhaps the match will be stopped. Tony continuing to lay him in there. Gets this big 300-pounder. Another. How much can a man take? Well, Luke Graham just flicked out there again. No reversal by Tony Garea. Luke off the ropes, waiting for him. Tony Garea back on his back. Nice for him. A slugfest ensuing here. Dick Worley pulls Garea away. Steps in the middle. Apparently, time has expired.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's the time limit. The official decision, draw.
Time limit has expired, and it is a draw officially. We shall return with Victor Rivera.
There's a long stretch of indoor weather coming up, and you'll want the house looking ship-shaped. Well, just in time, Siemens is having a sizzling wall unit sale. Three-piece 90-inch units to set off your room and provide all the storage and display space you'll need for only $449. Or if your wall is wider, 93-inch units for $599. A Siemens wall unit gives your room that decorator look. So measure your space, see Siemens wall unit sale, and save.
See Siemens first.
Nothing to
destroys a new car quicker than Mother Nature and her favorite killer, rust. But now new car dealers have Polyglycote rust-proofing shield. When tested against the seven leading rust-proofing products, only Polyglycote stopped rust through completely. That's why only Polyglycote can offer the incredible seven-year warranty. Polyglycote rust-proofing, so effective its warranty is renewable. Total 14-year protection. And if during that time your car has rust through, we'll repair it free. So forget about rust for 14 years with Polyglycote rust-proofing shield.
From Space Age Technology comes a new idea in fitness, the DynaFit computerized fitness system. A computer stores 32,000 pieces of information, so when you enter your age, weight, and sex, the DynaFit programs and monitors your exercise session, tells when you're going too fast or too slow, watches your pulse rate, shows calories burned, and other vital information right at your fingertips. In minutes, the DynaFit displays your fitness score so you can see and measure improvement from day to day. Compete against yourself or others.
DynaFit is fun. A good workout anytime, even while you're watching TV.
Remember, there's so much more to physical fitness than just good weight and appearance. And you're never too busy to keep fit on a DynaFit.
Learn how DynaFit can be the key to your fitness program. For a free booklet, phone 800-528-6050. Toll free.
That's 800-528-6050. Don't delay.
Call right now. 800-528-6050.
This next match is set for one ball with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first the manager, the Hollywood fashion blade, Flassie, Fred Flassie. From Panama City, Panama, weighing 221 pounds, Steve King. And his opponent, from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing 253 pounds, Victor Rivera.
Victor Rivera, along with his manager, Fred Flassie, against Steve King. Here we go with the action.
The following is commercial in content. All-Star Wrestling returns to Torrington, Connecticut, 1 week from tonight. Scheduled to compete on the wrestling spectacular set for Torrington at the high school will be Chief J. Strongbow, surely one of the all-time great competitors in the Worldwide Wrestling Federation. J. Strongbow, joined on the card by Dino Bravo and many others as wrestling appears in Torrington 1 week from tonight.
Steve King. Victor Rivera, all over his opponent, Steve King, in a moment. Warm smash, and Rivera sends King down to the canvas again. Superstar Billy Graham stole the championship belt from Bruno Sammartino. Have we had such a response over what happened last week when Victor Rivera was involved and Fred Flassie was involved along with Spiros Arion, when in fact they met Peter Maivia and Bob Backlund? And the happenings of last week have upset the wrestling world like no other event. Arnold Skolin, as many of you recall, left this ring a beaten, dejected individual. Bob Backlund took tremendous amounts of punishment from Rivera, Arion, and then from what he thought was his greatest friend in Peter Maivia. This unquestionably has rocked the wrestling world. And as stated before, we will have commentary on that and an explanation from one of the principals later on in the program.
Rivera with a forearm smash knocks him right back down, though. Rivera removing that protective padding when he throws Steve King to the buckle there. Look at Fred Blassie gesturing. He loves this type of thing. There's no such word as fair play in the vocabulary of Fred Blassie. King on the concrete floor now. Fred Blassie peering down over him. Rivera ramming the head of Steve King and his opponent into the apron of the ring, and Blassie kicks the shoulder. Steve King on the apron and again suffers the forearm smash of Victor Rivera. Can you believe this? Rivera, well, there's no contest here, at least not at the moment. And to someone like Steve King, not only is he asked to face Victor Rivera in the ring, but outside there's always the presence of Fred Blassie. And in typical Fred Blassie fashion, Victor Rivera snatches Steve King up when he knows full well he could have had a count of three. Suplex. Rivera for yet another cover. Hooks the leg and the tights. And it's over.
Nights ahead, which makes this the ideal time for getting your bedroom cozy and warm. And to help you do it, Siemens is having a super three-piece bedroom package sale. At $4.99, these restful traditional lines. This all but contemporary for $5.99. At $6.99, a sturdy colonial for the elegance of the Mediterranean. All but contemporary styling at $7.99. And this smart mirrored bamboo at $9.99. See Siemens bedroom sale and save.
Professional wrestling has the pleasure of returning to Long Island at the Nassau County Coliseum on an upcoming Friday night, the 17th of November. And scheduled to grace the squared circle on this occasion, ladies and gentlemen, will be the manager standing to my right and all his sartorial splendor, if you would, the Grand Wizard of Wrestling, as you will be representing superstar Billy Graham on this occasion.
That is correct. Once again, the fortunate people in the Long Island area will be able to have a visual feast as they see in action the great, the former Worldwide Wrestling Federation heavyweight champion, the man with 1,000,001 muscles, superstar Billy Graham, in all his glory, blazing his way to still another great, grand, and victorious match. That's what's going to happen, Mr. McMahon.
The Grand Wizard, confident that superstar Billy Graham will attain victory in Long Island at the Nassau County Coliseum.
Full clean waters of the North Atlantic produce what may be the world's finest tasting fish. This is why Arthur Treacher's restaurants go out of their way to serve only 100% North Atlantic prime white fillet. No bones about it. And when you combine this fresh, clean taste with Arthur Treacher's famous secret recipe, you'll appreciate the difference real quality can make. It is something else.
Arthur Treacher's, we are from the land.
This match is set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my left, from Sicily, weighing 241 pounds, Tony Russo. And his opponent is accompanied by his manager, the Hollywood fashion plate, Flassy Fred Blassie. He is from Athens, Greece, weighing 268 pounds, the Iron Greek, Spiros Arion.
So the Iron Greek
set to face Tony Russo, and we're set for the action to commence.
Posing for this commercial timeout, All-Star Wrestling returns to Shirley, Long Island, Monday night, the 6th of November, scheduled to compete on the wrestling card. In Shirley, Long Island, will be Spiros Arion, the Iron Greek. As Arion is joined up by the Phenom, Crusher Blackwell. Blackwell, 424 pounds of him, appears in Shirley, Long Island on Monday night, the 6th of November.
Goes to work on a left leg, and Tony Russo with a commanding position at this moment. Russo appears to be a bit hesitant, though, to move in on Arion. Arion lifts the boot the second time, the third time. Down goes Russo. Arion still favoring the left leg a bit, but using the right one to his advantage, kicking. Brutal right hand by Arion. Blatant chokehold. Referee says, bring it up. Perhaps you can hear the sound of the blows of Arion landing against the chin a moment ago. Russo, I better go back to what he does best there, are the leg dives and leg takedowns that he was using earlier. Arion, a merciless type individual, in the same pattern and mold of Victor Rivera, and of course both individuals guided by Freddie Blassie. Kick by Russo. Russo sending Arion off the rope now and catches him off guard. Arion had the air and some hair there with a left hand and hammering with the right. Arion to the rope. Knocks Russo to the canvas. Arion off the rope again. Once again, Russo picking his way back up. All right. Russo behind Arion. Could not pull him off the ropes. Had the hips hooked, but could not quite put Mr. Arion away. For the count of one, two, and three. Russo certainly had his shining moments in that match, but in the end, it's Spiros Arion who chalks up the victory. Let's get the official time, if we may.
The time of the match, 3 minutes, 12 seconds, and your winner, Spiros Arion.
Spiros Arion with a hard-fought victory over Tony Russo, who I'm quite certain surprised Mr. Arion a moment ago. Scheduled up later on, ladies and gentlemen, as we outline, we'll be seeing the Yukon Lumberjacks. Eric and Pierre in a non-title tag team match, also scheduled to see action in this squared circle, will be the super heavyweight. One of the greatest super heavyweights in professional wrestling in Crusher Blackwell. Then, of course, from there, the six-man tag team match with Dino Bravo, Larry Zbysko, joining forces with S.D. Jones, meeting Johnny Rodd, Stan the Man Stasiak. Joining those two will be the Russian Bear, Ivan Kulov.
Professional wrestling returns to Connecticut, returning to New Haven, Connecticut on a Sunday night. The 12th of November will be a wrestling spectacular second to none. And one of the principals, ladies and gentlemen, scheduled to compete will be the individual standing to the right of Captain Louis Albano, former Worldwide Wrestling Federation champion, Ivan Kulov.
I know they have good talent here in the East Coast, but I just hope that they have the finest up against Ivan Kulov. In fact, I know they do because I've signed for this match, and I'm looking forward to it in the New Haven area. New Haven, perhaps one of the largest cities in Connecticut, and we're really looking forward to it. It's, let's say, a stepping stone to the title of Bob Backlund. By taking this victory, and with a decisive victory, I believe our next step will be a title match against Backlund. That's what I'm looking forward to.
Lou Albano. Very soft-spoken.
TB, you think? You hope, man.
Confident, however, that Ivan Koloff will achieve victory in New Haven, Connecticut.
Allergy.
Meineke Discount Mufflers shatters prices. Any make, any model. American cars, Japanese cars, German cars, English cars, Swedish cars, French cars, you name it.
That's right, Molly. Thousands of car owners have taken advantage of Meineke Discount Mufflers prices. So when you need a muffler, check Meineke's low prices. It's easy.
Because chances are there's a Meineke shop near your home. Drive in today.
Mufflers install from as low as $16.93. No charge for installation. A real value.
Here's a good idea for Halloween. Wrigley's gum. My kids love it, and it's the treat I approve of. That's because I know Wrigley's Spearmint, Double Mint, Juicy Fruit, or Big Red Gum is a wholesome treat for kids. It won't spoil their appetite. Each stick is neatly wrapped, ready to hand out, and there's great value in a variety of package sizes. I like this new 50-stick bag. Wrigley's gum is the best idea for Halloween.
Get the wholesome Halloween treat kids love. Wrigley's gum.
The following match is a special tag team attraction and is set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the ring from Madrid, Spain, weighing 236 pounds, Joe Rodriguez. And his partner from Puerto Rico, 228 pounds, Juan Lopez. And their opponents. They are the current Worldwide Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions from the Yukon, total combined weight 551 pounds, Eric and Pierre, the Yukon Lumberjacks.
So the Lumberjacks set to meet a tag team combination joining forces for the first time, giving away a lot of weight inside to the Lumberjacks, and Joe Rodriguez and Juan Lopez were set for the action here in the tag team match.
Falling is brought to you by Capital Wrestling Corporation. Once again, professional wrestling appears in New Jersey, in Flemington, New Jersey. The date, Wednesday night, the 8th of November. Scheduled to appear in Flemington, New Jersey on this date will be Gargantuan Gorilla Monsoon. Joined on the card by Victor Rivera, Tony Garea, Spiro Therion, Luke Graham, and many others as wrestling appears in Flemington, New Jersey. On Wednesday night, the 8th of November.
Juan Lopez, or rather, Juan Lopez tag team partner, Joe Rodriguez, looks like a midget in there compared to Eric. Eric, really a big man, the bigger, the larger of the two Lumberjacks. Extends the hand, and here comes Pierre. A couple of weeks ago, as we outlined earlier, it was certainly a pleasure to have with us the living legend of professional wrestling, Bruno Sammartino, who added quite a bit of color commentary, actually, to the events as they progressed, so much so, as a matter of fact, that, fans have been sending telegrams and everything else demanding that they see more of Mr. Sammartino. And we have just been given a notice that you will be seeing more of the living legend. As a matter of fact, Bruno Sammartino will join us right here next week for more color commentary and, of course, giving his expertise as far as the inside of professional wrestling is concerned. And that will add a new dimension to championship wrestling. So we certainly welcome Bruno Sammartino next week, along with our regular crew here, adding a new dimension, as we outlined here, in the championship wrestling. Always lots of action happening here in one way or another. Scheduled up later on, Crusher Blackwell will meet individual competition. We outlined earlier the tag team tandem of Zbyszko, Bravo, and Jones will meet Stasiak, Rods, and Ivan Koloff. Joe Rodriguez, no match for the Lumberjacks, not in size.
Sack is made. Entering the ring now will be Juan Lopez from Puerto Rico. Listed at 230 pounds, I believe, and has quite a bit of height to him. If you can fill that frame out, he could be something to reckon with here in the World Wide Wrestling Federation. Lopez obviously lacking in experience, though, to a certain degree. The knee right into the midsection, and Pierre lays him in. Lopez whipped into Eric. Extended hand tag there and wide open now. Juan Lopez. Eric really lays the left hand in. Eric chopping down Juan Lopez. Lopez coming off the rope. The foot of Eric right up into the solar plexus. Eric hurting his hand there a moment ago. Perhaps hurting the head of Lopez a bit more. Legal hold applied, a rather unusual one, however. Lopez attacking the midsection that was wide open. Runs over to attack his partner, Joe Rodriguez. Rodriguez moving in there. Tries to haul his man out. Can't quite do it. Tag was made, and there is Pierre. A scoop by Pierre and a slam. Rodriguez with a series of wild rights and lefts and just started to land a bit there. Working on the midsection, and Pierre says, no, I've had enough of that. Eric taking a wide open shot there. Eric stomped down on the side of the head of Joe Rodriguez. A right hand clips him across the jaw, and Rodriguez thinks it's a good time to tag his partner. Thus far, very little competition for Lou Albano's Lumberjacks. Whipped to the rope, hit it off. Ooh, my, did you see that? What an elbow smash that was. Tag made now. Pierre through the ropes. Sending Rodriguez tag team partner Lopez off the rope. Down for two and three, it's over. So neither Rodriguez nor his partner Juan Lopez could do much with these overpowering lumberjacks in a non-title event here. Let's get the official time.
Time of the match, 6 minutes, 16 seconds, and your winners, the Yukon Lumberjacks.
So Eric and Pierre chalk up a victory for themselves. Let's go back and take a look at some of the action we saw on the latter stages. Lopez whipped off, and watch this now. My goodness. That elbow really had the impact sent in there by Eric. We shall return, ladies and gentlemen, with Crusher Blackwell.
This is the man who turned the wrestling world upside down last week. This is the man who turned on the Worldwide Wrestling Federation champion, Bob Backlund, and his manager as well. And this is the man who on the 20th of November in Madison Square Garden will oppose Bob Backlund for the championship. Your explanation, please.
I have no explanation whatsoever, Mr. McMahon. But I know one thing, that I've got this Backlund where I wanted him to be. Backlund, look forward, and you look straight at me in the eye when you're facing me in the garden. Because of what you did in the past, you used me and your manager. No more. because this time I'm going to teach you a lesson that you have never been taught before.
Maya Villa attempting to teach Bob Backlund a lesson in Madison Square Garden.
Once in a blue moon, a new car emerges, an extraordinary car, destined for a place in the sun. This is the 1979 version of the Pontiac Grand Prix, carrying on the grand style in the classic tradition, offering special attention to the driver, with perhaps the handsomest dash on the highway. The Pontiac Grand Prix, for the individual who wants to set himself apart.
This match is set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing, from Butte, Montana, weighing 237 pounds, Johnny Ringo. And his opponent, from Stone Mountain, Georgia, weighing 420 pounds, Crusher Blackwell.
Crusher Blackwell from the mountains of Georgia against Johnny Ringo. Immediately following this match, we will have commentary with one of the principals that was involved in that melee of last week. We'll have more reference to that in a moment as the Grand Wizard is lifted ever so gingerly over the top rope by Big Crusher Blackwell. The bell has rung and we're set for the action.
The following is commercial in nature. The Paramount Samoan Chief Peter Maivia set to appear in Fairfield, Connecticut. Friday night, the 10th of November, Peter Maivia will be joined on the card in Fairfield, Connecticut by Eric N. Pierre, the Yukon Lumberjacks. Joined on the card as well by Stan the Man Stasiak, the special heart punch specialist. And we look forward to wrestling appearing in Fairfield, Connecticut on this date, Friday night, the 10th of November.
Johnny Ringo reversing things a moment ago and going to work on the wrist. Blackwell hooks the rope. Referee says the hold will have to be broken. We'll start all over. Blackwell favoring that massive left wrist a bit. Say that Blackwell can really move for a big man. He really don't have any conception of just how quick Crusher Blackwell is until he's put to the test. And thus far in this match, he really hasn't been put to the test. He only moves when he has to. Ringo had better resort to some mobility, because if he's just lying there receiving these kicks and what have you from Crusher Blackwell, it'll be a very, very short match. Oh, bear hug by Blackwell. Blackwell credited as being one of the strongest athletes in professional wrestling. Uno, right hand, breaks it up. Nice one over there by Johnny Ringo. Blackwell, the individual, likes to use his enormous power to his advantage. Oh, no! Oh! Blackwell picked up a head of steam from one side of the ring to the other. Referee says, bring it up. Not before it has its effect on Johnny Ringo. Blackwell will stay there as long as he can with that chokehold, until the referee insists the hold be broken. Ringo unable to find any measure at all to counter that awesome, immense bulk
of Crusher Blackwell. Oh, but wait! Blackwell sent in there! A right hand by Johnny Ringo, and Blackwell is rocked. Ringo all over big Crusher Blackwell. Blackwell's legs a bit left. Blackwell sends Ringo to the ropes. Ooh, and collared him. All it takes is one blow for Crusher Blackwell to turn things around to his favor. Blackwell ramming that head into the shoulder. Over by the count. One, two, and it's over. So Crusher Blackwell putting the finishing touches on Johnny Ringo. Blackwell put to the test to some extent. But I'll tell you, there are a lot of people here at the Worldwide Wrestling Federation that think that this man is unbeatable, believe it or not.
The time of the match, 4 minutes, 24 seconds, and your winner, Crusher Blackwell.
Crusher Blackwell victorious, and we shall return. But before we go, let's have our special interview, as we outlined earlier. As we were given to understand, we will have an interview with one of the principals who was involved in the melee we saw last week. And he is with me at this moment to my right, Fred Blassie. Now, last week, we saw you accompany Victor Rivera and Spiro Zarion in the tag team match against Bob Backlund and his, of course, partner Peter Maivia. Would you describe the actions that happened and why they happened?
McMahon, this is a wrestler who's been reborn again, talking about Peter Maivia. You know, for weeks and weeks I've been talking to him, showing him, telling him what has been happening to him right along. He could not see it, but finally he's seen the light.
Finally he's seen the light.
That Backlund was using him, just like Chief J. Strongbow used him. And I finally made him see the light. Blassie's charm finally made it paid off.
How was Backlund using it?
He took him as a tag team partner so he wouldn't have to wrestle him as his individual and defend his title. And Blassie's charm finally paid off. That is spelled charm, M-O-N-E-Y. Just like all the rest of these guys have fallen in line. First Spear Sarion, they said it couldn't be done. And Blassie's charm, M-O-N-E-Y, paid off. And then I took Victor Rivera out of the welfare line. And that charm paid off again, M-O-N-E-Y. And now it's paid off again by Savage Samoan. Chief Peter Maivia. Now we want Tony Garea, Larry Zbysko, Dominic DiNucci, Dino Bravo. And then we want the rest of those pencil neck geeks. Chief J. Strongbow, that hypocrite. That's who we want. That's right. He's the one that started all this rigmarole and tried to sideswipe this Samoan. The Samoan, he's a very gentle soul. He should have been told. And I was the one that told him to see the light. That's why he joined Blassie's army. He's now in my army. And I guarantee, Bob Backlund, we're coming after your title next. That's right. The Savage Samoan is in Blassie's army now. He's seen the light. He's been reborn.
So we have the apparent rebirth of Peter Maivia, according to Fred Blassie. We shall return in a moment.
Blassie's army!
This one's perfect for us.
Perfect, yes. But I bet it's out of stock and we'll have to wait.
Rock, Rockford has hundreds of Donahue sets for immediate delivery.
Yeah, and they'll probably charge us a fortune to deliver it.
Rockford delivers free in New York and New Jersey.
Wow, can you imagine how much this gorgeous set costs?
Rockford prices are lower than you've ever dreamed.
At all five Rockford showrooms, in-stock furniture is delivered free to New Jersey and New York in only 10 working days.
Psst. Know how to buy a used car cheap? At a nationwide auction. The big auction is this Sunday at noon at Kings County Nationwide in Brooklyn at 3rd Avenue and 20th Street. Come in and inspect the cars Monday through Friday from 10 a.m., then make your bid on Sunday at noon. Always over 100 cars and free door prizes, too, at Kings County Nationwide, 3rd Avenue at 20th Street in Brooklyn. For details, call 499-6161. 499-6161.
I'm chewing gum again. It's wonderful. For years, I couldn't because gum stuck to my dental work, but now there's Freedent gum. It doesn't stick, so I can enjoy all the pleasures of chewing gum again. The delicious flavor, fresh, clean breath and refreshing taste. All that's possible again with Freedent Gum from Wrigley's. It comes in peppermint and spearmint. You'll love it.
Feel free to chew Freedent.
It won't stick to most dental work.
Freedent Gum.
This is the final event. It is set for one fall to the curfew. It is a special six-man tag team match. Introducing in the corner to my left, from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, weighing 241 pounds, Larry Zbysko. And his partner, from Montreal, Canada, 248 pounds, Dino Bravo. And their partner, from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing 246 pounds, Special Delivery Jones. And their opponents to my right, from Brooklyn, New York, 241 pounds, the unpredictable Johnny Roz. And his partner, from Buzzards Creek, Oregon, weighing 272 pounds, Stan the Man Stasiak. And their partner, from Moscow, Russia, 263 pounds, the Russian Bear, Ivan Koloff.
So there we have the principals. And this will be a one-fall, six-man tag team match, and here we go.
Pausing for this commercial timeout, the Polish power, Ivan Putski, set to return to these parts on Saturday night, the 11th of November. On Saturday night, the 11th of November, Ivan Putski is set to grace the squared circle of Bergen Field, New Jersey, when wrestling appears at the Bergen Field High School. And the Polish power, joined by SD Special Delivery Jones and many others, as wrestling returns to Bergen Field.
Perhaps in a bit of trouble. Nice reversal. No, that's Koloff. Bravo moving in. Oh, yes, sir. Koloff extended the hand and was able to tag Stan the Man, and Stasiak now moving in with Bravo at quite a disadvantage indeed. Across the back. However, it shoved Bravo into S.D. Jones, who was waiting. Johnny Roth hauls him in. Over to him. Rod for the knee to the chest. S.D. Jones over to Stan the Man, who makes the tag.
Punch attempt, block, oh, nice maneuver. Oh, yes, sir.
Stasiak wasted no time in getting out of bounds. Koloff gets more of the same, and now Zbysko caught off guard. But no, he's right there. Zbysko runs into the knee of the Bear, and Koloff right on top of Larry to take advantage of it. Right across the top of the head. Johnny Rods off the ropes, kicking into the neck area. Rods with a hard right hand. Pushes Zbysko into the corner. Triple team effort here. Vicious threesome on the part of Johnny Rods. Pull off and stand the Man. Slugfest developing here. Toe-to-toe action with Zbysko and Stan the Man. Oh, Stan the Man holds to the near side. However, Rod's catching Zbysko off guard and from behind. And once again, Stan the Man's in control. The tag again made, and Johnny Rod's prevents Zbysko from tagging one of his two tag team partners. Off the rope, no! Sunset flip, one, two! Can't quite put him away. Bravo now through the ropes, and Rod backs up a bit. Johnny Rod
whipped through to the far side. Koloff getting more of the same. Knee lift. Finally, Koloff leaving the area, but not before Johnny Rods has taken command of the situation. Koloff tagged again. Bravo in serious trouble. So thus far, the strategy obviously apparent here as Koloff, Stan the Man Stasiak, and Johnny Rods want to keep Bravo away from his partners. Johnny Rods off a top rope, right down to the small in the back. Rods whipped there to the buckle again. Johnny Rods once again climbs the rope to add an additional impact. Bravo holding his own at the moment. Rods coming off the rope. Oh, what a fat body drop. S.D. Jones will step through the squared circle. Rods unable to tag one of his partners. Good butt by Jones. Rods ripped to the rope. Jones was right there. Koloff right through now. Apparently Rods tagged Koloff. Stand the Man having no regard for the rules at all. All six wrestlers in there having at it. And Ivan Koloff took off. Pandemonium broke loose there in the six-man tag team match in the latter stages. We anxiously await this decision.
The time of the match, 5 minutes, 35 seconds. And your winners, the team of Larry Zbysko, Dino Bravo, and special delivery, Jones.
Wow, apparently a decision on the part of referee Dick Worley. And the decision made, and apparently we have victors of Bravo Zbysko and SD Special Delivery Jones. Now, next week, ladies and gentlemen, Stan the Man Stasiak will again return to this ring, although he will meet individual competition. One of the principles, as a matter of fact, that he faced here in the six-man tag team match. It'll be a most interesting situation when Dino Bravo, who is undefeated thus far in individual competition, faces the master of the heart punch in Stan the Man Stasiak. Also, as we outlined earlier, scheduled to join us right here in the broadcast booth will be, ladies and gentlemen, the living legend of professional wrestling, the one and only Bruno Sammartino, who will, of course, impart his wisdom from the inside point of view, something that we've blocked here for quite some time on Championship Wrestling. It'll add certainly a new dimension to Championship Wrestling as next week Bruno will join us in addition to the feature match as we outlined earlier, Dino Bravo facing Stan the Man Stasiak. Until then, this is Vince McMahon saying so long from ringside.